Let's move forward and hear what another big head, talking head on TV is saying about New Orleans. Here is Stephen A. Smith. Why isn't he showing more love?
Well, because he's playing in New Orleans and because we know that they're not going anywhere collectively as a team. Chances are they're going to get bounced in the first round, and at the very least, you know, at the latest possible time, the semifinals. That's why. When you look at this team, and you know he doesn't have much of a team around him. Jrue Holiday can play. We understand that. DeMarcus Cousins, Boogie Cousins, he's down and out right now. He's out for the rest of the season with the Achilles. But the bottom line is we didn't view this team as somebody that was elite. Alvin Gentry has something to do with that as well. I respect the hell out of him. He was a great assistant coach for Golden State. He was a damn good coach, at least for a couple of years in Phoenix. But overall, the pressure's on him to really step up and get it done. Now, they are 34-26, they're 8 games above 500. They're in the Western Conference. If they were in the Eastern Conference, they'd clearly be one of the top three teams, because this brother, Anthony Davis, is one of the top three players in the world. He is a flat-out superstar. He's been averaging at least 10 rebounds a game for the last 5 years. Not to mention the fact this is the second year in a row he's averaging better than 28. He simply has the entire offensive arsenal at his disposal, not to mention how formidable he is defensively. The only debate is, where is he in the top three in the entire NBA? But we're not talking about him enough, because we don't have expectations for New Orleans. And as a result, because of that, you look at them knowing that they're not really going anywhere, and you say to yourself, all right, he's great, but that's the only reason. He's in the New Orleans market, and it's a team that's not really expected to do any kind of damage come postseason time. They're not even considered top three or four in terms of the Western Conference. That's the problem.
Look, that's Stephen A. Smith analysis on the New Orleans Pelicans. Bottom line, New Orleans not going nowhere. He respects the hell out of Alvin Gentry, a good assistant coach. So, I mean, to be honest with you, his comments were actually more in line, closer to reality than the other guy's comments was. But this, again, is why we have the Pelican postgame report. Because we cover the team. We watch the team every game. We cover this team. We know this team. We know this team better than these talking heads do. These other talking heads are only watching the teams that they're familiar with. Every now and again, they'll jump on there and they'll talk about the Pelicans, one line mentions, and the rest of it, they're in love with Cleveland, they're in love with Golden State, they're in love with whatever hot team is out there, Houston Rockets right now, who's wheeling off 13 in a row. Pelicans, man, they're valid. You got to talk about it. It's 7-game winning streak. Anthony Davis joining people like Bob McAdoo as the only players in history to record 50-plus points and 15 rebounds and 5 blocks in a single game, man. Come on, man. You know, and the Pelicans not going nowhere. You might not have any expectations of the Pelicans, but we do. We have expectations of the Pelicans. And our expectations of the Pelicans is the fact that we know that the Pelicans will not only make the playoffs, but they will have a run in the playoffs. They have climbed into the top four, top five teams. There is very few teams that want to see the Pelicans playing like this right now. Anthony Davis right now is playing on another level. Jrue Holiday is playing. This is his best basketball self that anybody ever seen. So we have expectations of the Pelicans. We expect the Pelicans to not only get in the first round, but actually win a first round matchup, which will carry them into the semifinal round. You know, so I mean, into the next round of the playoff cycle. But you don't have any expectations of this team. We do. And when you talk about knowing it, you only mention a few people. Notice how they only talk about the people, the guys that you actually, that the national people that follow the sport actually would talk about. They'll talk about Anthony Davis. He had a little name. Well, what about Jrue Holiday? We understand Jrue Holiday is doing this, that, during. Then talk about DeMarcus Cousins. DeMarcus Cousins been sat down, man. He been sat down. And the Pelicans been winning games since DeMarcus Cousins been sat down, man. You know, why are you not talking about Rondo? Why are you not talking about the contributions being made by Emeka Okafor? Why are you not talking about the contributions being made by Nikolai Mirotic? Why are you not talking about the contributions being made by Ian Clark? Why are you not talking about the contributions being made by the rest of the Pelican role players, and the fact that the assistant good assistant coach, head coach L. Gentry, actually is open up his philosophy, and they are coaching better, and the team is playing better than they have at any point of the season, even when they had DeMarcus. They do not follow this team. They just tune it in just to get a little bit and then turn it off. That's what these national guys do. They're not fans of the Pelicans. They're not fans of New Orleans Pelicans. They're not fans of the team. If they did, they will have a better and higher talk when they come down to them. But that's why the Pelican post game exists, because of people like that only talk about the mainstays, the big guys. They don't mention the role guys, because this team is winning because Anthony Davis is playing at another level. Jrue Holiday is right up under him, and the team is playing better as a team. And that is to do with everybody coaching better, everybody training harder, everybody paying more attention, everybody doing the extra that it takes to win games as a team. He failed to mention that. But he did say, hey, we don't have any expectations. Hey, Stephen A., you might not, but we do. We have expectations of the Pelicans. So keep drinking the Kool-Aid on Golden State and just keep on talking about the big boys, because that's what they do. Thank you, and we'll talk about our Pelicans.